What is a beloved community? In its simplest form, it refers to a community where you are beloved, a place where you can be yourself, thrive, and help others around you grow as well. Auntie Puanani Burgess is a kupuna, culture facilitator, storyteller, and the creator of a ceremony called Building a Beloved Community, which uses traditional oral Hawaiian storytelling to lay the foundations for beloved communities. For my senior project, I animated the story Boy with a Gift to share the story that everyone has a gift. Even if you feel like you don't have one, you do. I present Boy with a Gift. Enjoy.
Aloha, Michelle. You know, in the work that I do in building the beloved community, there's a process I use which involves asking people three stories to tell. First is to tell the story of all of your names. And when you tell that story, you tell the story of your people and your family. The second story is to tell the story of your community, where you come from, and how that makes you feel. The third is to tell the story of your gift. That often is the hardest story to tell because it requires you to dig deep and to really honor something that is inherent in you that oftentimes is not seen by others. I did this story with a group of 11th and 12th graders at Waianae High School, young women and young men. We sat in a circle and we went around the circle and each one of them told their three stories, their name, their community, and their gift. Until we got to this one young guy, when it was his turn to tell his stories, he told the story of his name and his community. But when it came time to tell the story of his gift, he pushed back against me hard. And he looked at me straight in the eye and he said, "Miss, what kind of gift you think I get? I stay in this freaking special ed class. I get hard time read and math hard for me. And why you make me shame for asking me the kind of question, what's your gift? If I had gift, you think I'd be here?" So he just shut up and he shut down. And I felt shame because I made him shame. So I shut up and I shut down. Fortunately, in every community, there are always places where you can see everybody you like see and everybody you know like see. And so in Waianae, one of those places for us is Tamora Store. So I'm in Tamora Store and I'm pushing my wagon down the aisle and I see that boy and his back is faced toward me and all I can think of is run. And so I start to back up and I'm trying not to hit anything on the side and trying not to make any noise because I don't want him to turn around. I don't want him to yell at me and I don't want him to make me shame again. So I'm backing up and then he turns around and he looks at me straight in the eye and he says, "Auntie, I've been thinking about you, you know. I've been thinking what my gift that Auntie told me I get on gift, you know, so I better find him. So Auntie, I've been thinking about it, you know." So I looked up at him and I said, "So brother, what is your gift?" He said, "You know, I get hard time read and math hard for me. But Auntie, when I go on the ocean, I can call the fish, you know. And a fish, he come every time. Every time I can put food on my family table. And sometimes when I stay in the water, the shark, he come, you know, and he look at me. And I look at him and I tell him, 'Uncle, I'm not going to take plenty of fish. I'm going to take one, two fish just for my family. All the rest, I leave for you.' So the shark, he tell me, 'Are you cool, brother?' And I tell him, 'Uncle, you cool.' And so the shark, he go his way, you know, Auntie, and I go my way." I look at that boy and I think, you are invisible to them. They don't know the quality of your mind and your heart and your knowledge, your ʻike. And I think to myself, how do we make room for the gifts of all of our children? And how do we make these schools really be attentive to and begin to see and teach to the gifts of our children? But it begins with each one of us thinking about and knowing that we have gifts and having the patience to wait for the answer. So my question to you is, what do you bring to your community? What is your gift? Mahalo.